we are going to demonstrate the operation of the MSM DAI. So we will have three modules of that. Firstly, we will see the scalar control of PMSM. Then we will see the vector control, the field-oriented control of PMSM. And lastly, we will see the sensorless control of permanent magnet synchronous motor. So here you can see this is a permanent magnet synchronous motor, which is 1 HP rated and 2.4 ampere rated current. It is coming with loading arrangements, and it is Bang-Make motor. The company which is manufacturing the motor is Bang Electricals. Then we have the high power module developed by National Infotech. Going ahead, we have the ARM Cortex M4 kit, which will be rapid development if there is an advanced RAM. So this is an ARM Cortex kit, but you will get rapid development kit if you are purchasing advanced RAM. Also, the power connection I will show you. Firstly, we have the input of the variac coming from this MCB, and variac is we are using three phase variac, but we are using only single phase of that variac. So primary of the variac is coming from MCB, and secondary of the variac is going to our high power module. So you can see over here the variac, there is an input to the rectifier. It is three phase rectifier, we are giving only single phase, so it will generate 300 volt line to line, 300 volt DC link voltage at the inverter DC link. We have our conventional 6 IGBT DC link over here, and we have three phase output from coming from over here, here and here, three phase output. So we have connected one A meter on R phase, this is our current meter. This is Y and B, we are connecting yellow and blue, three phase of the motor. As well as we have taken the encoder, the position sensor, which is Omron mode made position sensor. So we have connected that sensor to our ARM Cortex kit. With all these arrangements, we are also providing the three phase current sensor card, which is inbuilt in this high power module. So we are sensing those three currents, IR, IY and IB, and we are feeding those currents to our controller. So basically this is the arrangement. So now what we will do is we will do V by F control of the permanent magnet synchronous motor. So in this arrangement we will give 270 volt around DC link, and we will turn on the drive. This is a basic user interface of the drive. You can see over here scalar control is shown over here, clockwise the direction of the rotor is shown over here. You can take it clockwise or counterclockwise, and the reference speed and measure speed. So right now drive is off condition, so you can, and you can change the rotation using just key, counterclockwise and clockwise. So we'll just start the drive. We have given 270 volt DC link right now. So by pressing the PD7 pin, we'll start the drive. So as you can see, in scalar control, it will take high current to synchronize with the voltage, and after that, after syncing, it will run on nominal current. You can see over here, this is the angle of the modulating signal and modulating signal itself over here. And this is how the motor is right now rotating. The angle, the theta, is derived using you can see theta is in phase with SVM, and theta is derived using our encoder. So now we will, the drive will initially take reference speed 500 rpm. So right now it is rotating at 500 rpm. Now we have to press the enter button to give command to drive to reach the reference speed. So I will press the enter button. It will slowly ramp up towards the reference speed. So we do not take any input signals for this operation, because this is a synchronous motor drive. So we will directly apply that frequency and required voltage to rotate the motor at that speed. So you can see over here, motor is exactly rotating at 2078 rpm, and it is in phase with our synchronous stator frequency. You can see the motor current is also normal, but you cannot load the motor, because if you will load the motor, in this case in scalar control, it may have occurred that the synchronism of the rotor get lost. So it is recommendable to not load the motor in scalar control. Now it is rotating at counterclockwise. You can make it clockwise, so you have to turn off the drive first. It will slowly ramp down the motor. After ramping down, I'll press the direction key, and that will change the direction. And I will turn on the drive, and the drive will rotate in clockwise fashion. You can see over here the angle of the rotor is changed. It is the other side. Okay, so that was all. We can see different waveforms. We have done space vector modulation of this drive, so we have the sector. You can see there are sectors over here. This yellow line is sector 0 to 6 sectors. We also have the set speed and actual speed graphs, and we also have all three VA, VB and VC on the DAC, digital to analog converter. We have two DACs, so we can get two signals. So we are deriving 7 types of different signals that you can see on the DSO while drive is in operation. So this is all about scalar control of permanent magnet drive. After this we will see vector control and sensorless control in other videos.